guys have heard of any of the National Treasure movies? Okay, well, the escape room is kind of like that. The last escape room I did was called The Art Heist, and in it I'd use a decoder and a black light to find some of the clues, which kind of was like Nicolas Cage when he used the lemon juice on the back of the Emperor's New Year. And so the escape room is like stepping into one of those movies. And so it's not surprising that a lot of people love the escape room. So according to the escape room directory, you can go to an escape room location in every U.S. state. So then you might think, how is the escape room different to our state, or how does it make our city special? So I'm here to explain how the escape room in Indiana are different than in other states and how they make our city special. The escape room promotes creativity and problem solving, and it's a great addition to our city. So I don't know if you guys know, but I'm going to explain what the escape room is. So basically the escape room is like a puzzle game. So you're in there for 60 minutes, you're with a group, and then you have to get out. And all of the clues are in the room. So if you don't get out in time, then you just, I guess, lose. But it's a really fun game to do with a group, with your family, and it's just a really good game. So the ones in Indiana and Fishers are really great because they're not part of chains. They're different and they're locally owned, so that makes our city special. So I talked with Mrs. Bohannon. She books for the escape room, and she loves how the escape rooms are locally owned. She loves how the escape rooms are different at each location. So then I asked her, how are the rooms different? And she said that some of the rooms are Hoosier themed, like Hoosier Hysteria. And I've actually done Hoosier Hysteria. And Hoosier Hysteria is basically you have to steal back a trophy, like an Indiana basketball trophy. And so obviously that's catered to Indiana. And there's also a lounge space where we can host birthday parties, and we even have restaurants that cater for our big events. So that's different because most escape rooms are kind of just like a doctor's office. You sit outside and you wait for your name to be called, and then they call you in and you do your escape room. But the Indianapolis and Fishers locations are different because you can sit outside with your friends, you can chat, you can have birthday cake, anything like that. And yeah, so it's a really great place for birthday parties. And if you call ahead, they will have an event, or they'll have a restaurant come in and cater for your event. So you don't even have to bring around food if you don't want. So this is the Fisher's location, lounge space. They don't really let you take a lot of pictures in the escape room for obvious reasons. If you take a picture of the escape room, it will spoil it for someone else. Because once you do an escape room, it's kind of hard to do it again, since you'll know where all the clues are located, and then you'll know how to get out. So this is the only picture I could find of the lounge, but behind it there's more lounge space, and there's huge long tables, so you can have events with friends. This is the Indianapolis location, which I've also been to, and again, there's more lounge space than this, but this is a really great place where you can take pictures. I'm sure you guys have seen all those pictures with like the get out or not quite or something like that. Some of those. So it says this is the Indianapolis one, and this family, they had the I got out, and they had the prizes that they won in the room there. You don't get to keep them, but you can take like a fun picture with your family. And then that's actually a birthday party I went to, and we didn't get out. We did the hardest one. Only 1% get out, but it was still a really fun time, and that was at the Fisher's location. So I talked to my brother, and he said that his favorite part about the escape room is that you can go in big groups and that you really get closer with the people you go with, because you have to work together, you have to work hard, and yeah, it's just a really great time. So we've seen what the escape room is and how the local escape rooms vary from chains. Now Marissa will tell you about where the escape rooms are located. Except Marissa's not here today, so I'm just going to go out to Diego.
All right, so starting off, there are two rooms called Race 1 and 2, and both of them you race against other people, basically to see who finds the parts of the cars to get prepared for the race. Now, if you don't get the parts, if you don't present the car 2 hours before the race starts, you will start in last place, And the night before, what happened was that somebody sabotaged the cars, and when the race was about to start, they found out. The Stalag 21, the American POV, I was told was one of the hardest ones that they could have, because they're supposed to, they land in Germany somewhere, and apparently they're supposed to get their plans, but you have an ally who's on the ground who's closer, and before somebody catches you, they're supposed to get the plans and get out as fast as possible.
This is the one I've actually done. It was really hard, and there's a 1% like get out rate. So most of the people obviously don't get out. It's really hard. There's several rooms to it, so the wall will like slide away to show another room, and then you'll have to find more clues in that room, and then you'll get out. But
1776 was during here a long time ago. It was during the Revolutionary War, and you're supposed to find a black powder inside Fort Sackville and find a way out before your enemies caught you. The night at the castle was somewhere in Europe when you guys land with your colleagues, and it's a castle called Neuschwanstein Castle, and you're supposed to go in there, and people are telling you that somehow the Mud King was drowned, but you find clues that supposedly he wasn't drowned. You're supposed to tell them that he was murdered and tell how, with the clues that you find in the castle. And the escape of the Titanic, there's supposed to be, you're like a server with other people, and when the ship goes down, there's someone who stays in a room with the cache of jewels, and you're supposed to help them out, find a way out to, without damaging the jewels, but returning them to the Macy's department. And here's a little video that I found.
Should all go try the escape room. It's a really fun thing to do with your family.